The Castle Cement Quarry at Ketton in Rutland has been producing limestone and clay for cement manufacture for 75 years. The machines that move, load and transport the raw materials are almost all produced by the Caterpillar Company. And to celebrate their 75th anniversary, Castle Cement put those machines on show to the public. To add to the event, they invited enthusiastic owners of older Caterpillar machines to bring them along and work alongside their younger but bigger brothers. That gave us the opportunity to bring you unique coverage of Caterpillars in the Quarry. The quarry at Ketton offers an almost ideal mixture of minerals for cement manufacture. To produce that essential construction component, you need limestone and clay, with smaller amounts of other materials to keep the mixture in balance. At Ketton, they're all present in the same location, all neatly stacked one on top of the other, ready for extraction and use.
We have the 375 with the back actors. One of those primary lays clay, because we need 20% clay to 80% limestone to make cement. So the 375 loads clay. That normally loads it into the 773s or the 775s.
Beneath the clay, a band of high-quality limestone can be removed and sold for building purposes, leaving a thick stratum of limestone, which is blasted daily and loaded by front-loader shovels into the biggest trucks.
Well, the stone was laid down in Jurassic times, it's Middle Jurassic limestone, and it's purely for making cement. We do have a building stone that we get out from time to time, about 3,000 tonnes a year. That's used in the Houses of Parliament, in Oxford and Cambridge universities, in most church spires and doorways. Well, normally what happens is we blast at the face, we blast every day. We bring down somewhere about 15,000 tonnes in one blast. That's just about one day's supply of limestone. That's normally loaded up by the 992G, which is a flagship of our machines, onto 777s, which goes directly to the crusher. A crusher can crush 2,500 tonnes an hour. What you have to remember, we try very hard to work only a five-day week. We don't intrude on the village or its surrounds on Saturdays and Sundays. So we have to have a large piece of equipment to make sure we do the production in the 5 days.
We'll come back to the quarry work later and take a closer look at all the new machines in the special working demonstration put on by Castle Cement to celebrate their 75 years at Ketton. First, though, we'll take a look at some special guests at the event, members of the Antique Caterpillar Machinery Owners Club of Great Britain, who've been invited to bring their own vintage tackle and work it alongside the new machines.
This is the third time that we've been asked by Castle Cement to mix in with all our modern machinery, with all the old, the vintage Caterpillar machinery and so on. And as you can see yourselves, what a wonderful event it is. And we're very grateful for Castle Cement to give us the opportunity to come and play with our machines. All these old machines, you would have seen these in here 30, 40, 50 years ago, even before the war, all doing their various different jobs of removing topsoil and overburden, and possibly on the roads, hauling haul roads, you know, and dump trucks as well, but all in a much smaller scale. There is, I believe, an Aveling Barford here which was bought new here. I don't know when, but possibly in the late 50s, early 60s, and it's here actually back again doing a few loads. It's a 10-tonner. It's it's a little bit smaller than the ones I got here at the moment, I think, which are 100 tonners, you know. But yes, they would have all been around. These type of machines would have been around when they first started, you know. We've got a D8 13A on a scraper, Stephen Kitchen. Anywhere there's a bit of muck shifting, Stephen is to be found. Then we've got another, a 2U, which is pushing a DW21 motor scraper, which is vintage, say, mid to late 50s. And that's given that a push to push load it, because they cannot load themselves, they're only two-wheel drive, you know. There's a 955 and a 977. 955 is based on the U-Series D4, which is called a 12A, model 12A, which has been restored very nicely. And there's a 977 up there, Donkey Start one, and that belongs to the same owner. Yes, they would have been around doing all what's happening here with the wheel loaders. So, yes, they would have been used in the same sort of job, you know.